What's up YouTube? So today I want to try out the Brave browser with, what is this? App number limit exceeded for NFC. What? That's weird. Yeah, so today I want to check out the Brave browser basically with a stylus. So this is the LG G4 stylus. It was a phone that sort of tried to copy what Samsung did, sort of. So I'm just gonna open this phone up here. I'm gonna take out the pen and let's see. So the first thing you can see here with this this stylus here is that it's a little bit different compared to the Samsung stylus. It has a little bit of a weight to it, which is pretty nice. Okay, let's see. So we have the Brave browser over here. I'm gonna tap on it. And let's just see how it looks when you type with the keyboard, okay? So this is the keyboard here. First thing is, I don't think it's as good as the default keyboard that you do get on Samsung phones, because first of all, I think that the emojis kind of suck. And there we go, tap. Something that we have seen here with GSM Arena also is they have this weird warning, which is kind of strange, because when I go to the site, I think it has the green bar there up at top. Okay, so the first thing I can see here is clicking is good with this stylus, on the G4 stylus, but scrolling is extremely smooth here as well. So I don't have to push it down super hard to make scrolling happen. Let's see how it works on the side. Yes, that also works pretty nice. Let's tap here, new phone. Okay, great. And I'm not really sure if many people would use a stylus like this to basically browse the internet, because I think that most people use a stylus to draw things. Here we have a new Xiaomi phone, Xiaomi Mi Mix 2S. You can see that a lot of new phones here are sort of copying the new iPhone X, because they have this traffic light dual rear camera. But you can see, for example, with this phone, it has this fingerprint sensor in there at the center rear side, something that the iPhone X is not having. Okay, so it works good. It's great speed here, and if I tap up here, I can see some quick information about stuff that they're currently blocking: two ads and trackers. You can see if scripts are being blocked, fingerprint methods, and you can disable this here if you want ads. Let's try out the tab feature. So the tab feature also works very nice. Let's try another mobile website, Phone Arena. I really enjoyed the .com one button tap on that a lot of phones have. Another website, and again, the good thing with the Brave browser is that it automatically blocks the ads, so you only get the quality experience, because for especially on phones, just because the screen is so small, ads kind of suck, because they basically are too big and they take up too much space. So yeah, quick little video here trying it out with the G4 stylus. If you want to download the Brave browser, then I will have a download link in the description. Works both for iOS and Android. And yeah, have an awesome day, everyone. Bye-bye.